You need to install an Endpoint Manager agent on devices you want to manage. Version 2024 makes the engine-based agent that was introduced in version 2022 the default. Click Configuration, Agent Configuration, Public Configurations. Here you will see agent configurations for the various operating systems that are supported. For this example, we will configure and deploy an agent to a Windows 10 device. If we open the configuration, we can see that there are many settings that can be configured. But for this example, we are just going to keep the default settings. If you've upgraded Endpoint Manager versions, or if you've applied an Endpoint Manager service pack, make sure you first select the Rebuild All button. This upgrades all agent components to the latest version. It can take a minute or so to run. Create Windows Agent installation files by right-clicking Default Windows Configuration. You have three choices here. The Create Engine-Based Agent Install Files option copies these files to a folder you select, EPM Agent Installer EXE, the Core's Public Certificate, a .0 file, a manifest file containing configuration details for the selected agent configuration, and a text file with the agent configuration name. The Create Engine-Based Agent Install MSI Unsigned option creates a single MSI file that includes the files from the first option. This option is mainly for Windows Group Policy Object deployments, since it can be difficult to deploy multiple files with a GPO. The Create Self-Contained Engine-Based Agent Install MSI option creates a single MSI containing full versions of all MSIs. This MSI is much larger because it includes all engine MSI files as well. This also is the only agent installation option that works on devices that don't have access to the core server during installation. You can run these packages manually on a device or deploy them as part of a group policy. If you want to deploy your agents remotely to devices that don't have an agent installed, the Unmanaged Device Discovery feature can help. To use this, you'll first need to provide credentials that give EPM access to those devices so it can install the agent remotely. Click Configure, Services, and open the Scheduler tab. Click the Change Login button. The credentials you provide should have administrator rights to the devices you will be deploying to, such as a domain administrator. Click Restart to restart the scheduler service. Now it's time to discover unmanaged devices. Click Configuration, Unmanaged Device Discovery. Click the Scan Network toolbar button. Enter the starting IP and ending IP address range, a subnet mask, and then click the Add button. Using a narrow IP range can shorten scan time significantly. In this case, I know the IP address of the device I want. When you're done adding ranges, click the Scan Now button. As the scan progresses, you'll see the device's found status increase. We can view this discovered Windows device in the Computers category. Use the Find filter to quickly limit the device list to strings matching data in the selected column. For example, here we're searching in the Device Name column. We can now remotely deploy the agent to detected devices. Select and right-click the devices you want. Select Deploy Agent. Click Next to make sure the agent configuration you want to deploy is selected. Schedule a time for the installation to begin. In this case, we'll leave it at Start Now. On the Summary page, finalize the task by selecting Deploy Agent. Monitor the deployment status and distribution scheduled tasks. You can see your managed devices in the network view under Devices, All Devices. Devices using an agent version that is older than what is on the core also appear under Devices, Devices with Older Agents. This view works like a filter and is a quick way to see which devices need an agent upgrade. A device with an older engine-based agent won't allow agent configuration changes until it has been upgraded. An older agent will still work normally otherwise. If devices using an engine-based agent need an upgrade, you can select them, right-click, and select Mark for Agent Upgrade. The next time the agent checks in, it will apply the upgrade. Agents check in once a day by default. If the device is contactable, you can make it check in immediately by selecting the Force Agent Check-In option. Again, these options are only available for devices with engine-based agents. When you select an agent configuration, you can see all devices using that configuration on the right. If you want a device to use a different agent configuration, drag it onto the configuration you want. For example, if I wanted this device to instead use the default Windows Server configuration, I can drag it from here and drop it. The configuration change will be applied the next time the agent checks in, unless you do a force agent check-in. These agent configuration changes apply quickly and don't require an agent uninstall/reinstall. In Administration Agent Health, you can check for agent issues on devices, such as installation, upgrade, and individual engine failures. Thank you, and we hope this video has been helpful.